This video tutorial I will explain how to test REST API with curl client. Here you can see database, and in this example we will use MySQL database. Here you can see Spring Boot demo, and it is a microservice application which exposes REST endpoints for creating the employee record, update the employee record, get the employee record and delete the employee record. And also it has REST endpoint to get the list of employee records. Here you can see curl client. We will see using curl client how to consume the RESTful web services which are exposed by Spring Boot demo application. Here you can see Spring Boot demo application with folder structure. Here you can see pom.xml. Here you can see employee service controller, which is a REST controller, and it has a create employee method which accept employee object, which is the request body, and to call this method we have to send request to this path, and method is post. This method is responsible for creating an employee record. Here I have defined a class application, which is a Spring Boot application. I am starting this Spring Boot application. Spring Boot application is started in 8080 port. Here you can see employee table, and it has two records. Next, what I am going to do is, using a curl client, I am going to send employee create request to Spring Boot demo application. Curl and HTTP method is post, and here is the URL, and here is the header section, and the employee object in JSON format. Press enter. Request reaches here. And here we got the output. Employee is created with ID 30. 30 is the primary key. Click on refresh, and here you can see one record is created. Here you can see update employee method, which accept ID and the employee object. And employee object is the request body. To call this method, we have to send request to this path. Here ID is the path variable, and HTTP method is put, and this method is responsible for updating an employee object in the employee table. Next, I am going to send update employee request to the Spring Boot application. Curl and HTTP method is put, and here is the request URL, and ID I am passing as 30. So this record I am planning to update, and this part is request header. And here you can see employee object in JSON format. Request came here. Here we got the output. Employee is updated successfully. Click on refresh, and this record data has been updated. Here you can see get employee method, which accept ID, and to call this method we have to send request to this path. Here ID is the path variable, and HTTP method is get. This method is responsible for returning the employee object based on the given ID. Next, I am going to send get employee request, curl command, and HTTP method is get. And here is the request URL. ID I am passing as 30. And here is the request header. Request reaches here. And here we got the output. ID 30, name Arun, age 50, and salary is 50,000. This record. Here you can see get employees method. To call this method, we have to send request to this path. And method is get. This method is responsible for getting all the employee records from the employee table. Next, I am going to send request to get all the employee records. Curl command, HTTP method is get, and here is the URL and the request header. And here we got the output. We got array of employee objects in JSON format. There are three records are there, and we got three employee records. Here you can see delete employee method, which accept ID. To call this method, we have to send request to this path. Here ID is the path variable, and method is delete. This method is responsible for deleting an employee record based on the given ID. Next, I am going to send delete employee request, curl command, and HTTP method is delete. Here is the URL. I am passing ID as 30. So this record I am going to delete, and the request header. The request reaches here. Here we got the output. Employee is deleted successfully. And here you can see one record is deleted from employee table. You can get Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.